One, sound check, good? Sound check. Yeah. One minute, huh?
So we just chat about what you saw so far for the day. You're speaking as well at the ceremony, right?
No, straight into that camera.
Yeah.
Well, good afternoon to you, everyone. To this very special event, a live broadcast of the Fisherman's Day activities at the Cattle-Cropping Field. Activities have been happening all day long. As a matter of fact, folks have been here since this morning, and we're in the back where all of the action is. Well, it's tapered off now because we've already closed off the time for weighing in for this Fisherman's Day competition for all of the various prizes. But we welcome you, and as we welcome you, we have with us the minister responsible for fisheries in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the Honorable Saboto Caesar. Good afternoon, thank you very much.
It's definitely an honor, a privilege to be here. And for those who are following, you should be on your way at home getting ready to come down to the Cattle-Cropping playing field. There's a buzz of activities taking place here. The fisher folk, they went out this morning very, very, very early. Excellent weather conditions, and they came in, the last boat came in at 4:30. They're weighing up the fish as we speak, and we are going to have a prize giving ceremony. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate all the participants this year. It is something that we look forward to here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines every year. And I realize that there are some persons who are here from Grenada and St. Lucia visiting with us and definitely enjoying the activities today.
Yes, well, the weather has been fantastic. We're feeling a bit of a sprinkle now.
Could not be better.
Yes. Excellent weather for fishing today. And we saw some very heavy catches coming in. And we'll hear all about that later on, because we have some prizes to distribute at the end of the ceremony. And that's what today's ceremony is about. There's a hive of activity here, Minister. Compared to the previous years, and particularly last year, you know, we had the COVID pandemic. The numbers that we are seeing this year from your observation?
The turnout definitely this year is much bigger. We have more persons who are coming out to support the activities. Of course, we are coming out of the pandemic, lots of prayer eruptions, and we are back to a state of normalcy. And I want to thank all the persons who continue to support Fisherman's Day each year.
Right, and as we get ready for the ceremony, we expect in a few minutes we'll get started, as a matter of fact. 5 o'clock is the time for the ceremony, but until then, let's chat a bit about the development in the fishery sector. Over the past year, there have been a number of developments, a number of initiatives catered to the fisher folk, and you may want to shed some light on those for the benefit of those who probably didn't hear about it.
It's very important that we begin with noting the critical importance of the Argyle International Airport, which basically is the biggest game changer in the fishery sector. When we opened the Argyle International Airport, it gave the investors locally, regionally and internationally greater confidence to buy boats, to be able to lease facilities. And this is all because we now have direct access to the United States of America, which is a major market. Since then, we have been able to export live lobster to Hong Kong. And we have opened several markets within the region and internationally. We then decided to establish the Fleet Expansion Initiative, and there is an agreement between the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines and the Kingston Cooperative Credit Union, where the government would put in 20%, and there's a financing arrangement whereby the purchase of the boat would be completed with the input of the Fisher and KCCU doing the rest of the financing. This program is already oversubscribed. We have 130 applicants already, and these persons have brought in all the prerequisites, and we are going to source these boats. Actually, we have about five companies already sourcing boats, stocking the spare parts which will be needed, and we are going to have a training program so that persons can improve the quality and the quantity of fish that we have in the country.
Right, but are there any specific targets for getting younger fishers into, you know, into this industry?
We continue to speak to the fisher folk. There are several organizations that are working with the youth. I've always noted that there's a need for an exceptional cadre of multi-talented producers. There are some persons who, however, are stuck in a mode whereby they want to go and fish in the morning, and by midday they are home so that they can sell their catch by 1 or 2 o'clock. But with the fleet expansion program taking another step to establish a solidarity fleet in the next few months, we are going to see an approach where we're going to have the development of an indigenous tuna fleet. This means that persons would have to go out for 2 or 3 weeks, spend more time at sea, and be able to harness more of the resources in the blue economy.
And the ceremony this afternoon, what are you looking forward to in terms of, you've been here, observed what has happened, in terms of the numbers, the expectations for the numbers when we come to the results later on?
We are going to have some big numbers, but I just want to note that because the weather is so good, there are some persons who went out and they met good grounds and they decided to miss the deadline.
Ah.
So 4:30, and I was advised that there are still 15 boats.
Oh, wow.
Still out at sea.
Wow.
Of course, they would not be a part of the competition as it pertains to them, well, really, they having their fish weighed to participate in the competition. But I welcome all the fish.
Indeed. Thanks very much, Minister. Yes. And we look forward to the ceremony. You expected to deliver some remarks at that ceremony in just a few minutes from now. So for those who are just joining us, we ask that you stay with us here at the Kaliakua Playing Field, the Kaliakua Fisheries Complex. And this is where everything is happening. From earlier today, maybe you passed by and you heard all of the music. There was some
You're supposed to be on your way to Kaliakua.
Yeah, yes, by now. Thanks, Minister.
Great. You.
And of course, there are things there for the children to be a part of as well. There's bouncing castle, there's food, there's snacks. So many things that you can take in here while we get ready for the ceremony at the Kaliakua Playing Field. As you realize, there's still persons coming in. You heard the minister said about 15 boats yet to come in. And if you have a look around, you can see that it's still rather busy. Generally, as we get closer to 5 o'clock, there's a taper off of the weighing that's happening. But I believe with so many boats still out, we'll continue to have them coming in, even though they may not necessarily be part of the competition itself. At least we welcome them with their catches after a long day for most at sea today. And as we witness now, another group coming in with their catch, properly secured, of course. And we believe another 14, if this is number 15, that's coming in here. About 14 more should be yet to land. But the cutoff time was actually at 4:30. Yes, 4:30 was the cutoff. But as the minister said, with several boats still out, they'll still get to bring in their catch. But even though it may not be part of the actual weighing happening here for the ceremony. The activities at the Kaliakua Fisheries Complex. Beautiful weather, a few sprinkles now as we speak to you, but it was great weather otherwise. Might be raining in some areas, but looking down towards the Grenadines, some beautiful weather in that direction. And the seas are relatively calm around for this time of year, so it's good to see that we're having we have some boats still out. Yes. You could see Beckway very well right now. I'm sure
that the visuals would give you, and the distance, the ferries plying their trade back and forth. And there are folks here enjoying every moment of this event. The children are on the playing field in the front, and they're enjoying some bonks and castle. They're enjoying some popcorn and some wonderful snacks and the family atmosphere. Here's just as great as fish and breadfruit. Yeah, quite a dish, and today is the day to enjoy this. Fried shark and breadfruit, yes, yes. Certainly a delicacy, and on a day like today, you shouldn't be having any chicken. Today is a day for fish, so some lovely shark and breadfruit there. Thanks very much. And just some of the things that you can see, you can take in here. Just a very lively atmosphere, very lively atmosphere. A gentleman has all right. Yes. So this gentleman is bringing in his catch. It just came off. And enjoying every moment of it. Enjoying every moment of it. So if you haven't gotten yourself ready to head to Kalyakoa, despite the little drizzle, very, very slight drizzle that we're having, it should be an afternoon, late afternoon, evening of event. Down on the playing field, as mentioned, where you can hear the music in the distance, is where a lot of the action is taking place in terms of the activities for children. The fishers have been out all day. Some of them are still out. Some may have come in already. But it's been a great one, and I'm not sure if we can see where they're preparing in the back. They're actually cleaning, or at least they're cleaning the fish in the back here. So I see they're sorting here. All right, so that process is happening here right now. We can have a first-hand view of one of the fishers preparing his fish for sale, and making sure he's given the instruction to put some ice on that so that properly preserved. Of course, you don't want anything happen to such a beautiful catch. We are seeing how the fish being prepared, right? So Wentworth, yes, tell me about the day's events today, and just reintroduce yourself. I'm not sure if our listeners heard you, so if you can just reintroduce yourself as we get going.
Well, Wentworth Harry, a fisherman, the president of the National Fisher Folks Cooperative. Really pleased for today as a fisherman and being in the competition myself today. I think it was really a tight competition today because the fish and them was really from us, and we had a lot of amberjack coming today, and not much dolphin as we expected, because you know, due to the climate change and everything, that we're not seeing that fish like how we used to see them before. But I have to say thanks to the sargassum seaweed that is passing through, and the fads that the government place in the waters that are carving the fish that fish and folks can still go and make a living. And it is a really plus to see how we celebrated our 46 years of Fisherman's Day. This year, last year we had a more scale long, but this year I think we go in full activities, and we had at least 60-70% of the boat who normally fishing take part in today's competition. catches might not be as we expected because we know what we are facing out there. And another thing I can say, due to the information that come out from Nemo yesterday to say that, stating that there will be a tropical wave that was passing through, we still met this competition, be a competition by braving the water, and the Most High God give us an opportunity that to shift it away that we could have really go and really take part in this competition. So I'm really happy.
What was the conditions like out there in terms of the general sea conditions? I mean, you were out there and you experienced it yourself.
Well, I could say it was the best for me and to all the rest time that we went out, because several years ago when we had Fisherman's Day at sea, we had Fisher Folks when missing at sea. We had a Fisherman's Day when parcels was coming from Canawan to Mustique, where 6 parcels did last their life, and that day as well too. And I think today that the water was real smooth, calm, nice, pretty good condition for fish. You couldn't, as a fisherman, today was a perfect day in terms of weather condition, visibility, and everything was totally 100%.
Awesome. Well, all the best, and I know that the fishing folk could be looking forward to the ceremony. I see the Honorable Prime Minister has just arrived here as well to take in some of the action, and wishing you all the best.
Okay, thank
yes,
you, sir.
Great. Yeah. Yes, that's Winsbud Harry of the Fishing Folk organization. We are the Calico playing field, and it's Fisherman's Day 2023 after a bit of a lull of activities over the past couple of years. A very scaled down year last year, and this year we now have something happening bigger than last year. Of course, the events are really unfolding here at the Karakwa Fisheries Complex, and we hope that you'll be able to join us here at Karakwa. And of course, it's a beautiful afternoon to get some fresh fish, and it's fresh off the boats, as we say, off the boats, waiting, and it's right here at the Karakwa playing field. In a few minutes from now, we expect the ceremony to begin shortly. Yes, Prime Minister, how are you? I see you just arrived. Come to get some fresh fish.
Yes, they're selling a lot of fish. I'm very happy to see that. And I heard your interview with Sabi.
Yes, yes.
And some of the boats enjoying it, so much they're still out. The only problem, they wouldn't be part of the competition.
Well,
but they catch more. They go catch more fish though.
Well, what are you looking forward to in terms of the ceremony here this afternoon?
Well, it's always a beautiful ceremony. I'll give the stats this evening, but there's been a lot of there's been an increase of 2022 over 2021 catch, and so far for the first 3 months of this year, it's significantly over the first 3 months of last year. So there's been fish and conch. There are one or two species which are better than others, as you normally expect. We have to make sure we get all the facilities in order, and that's taking place. And then we have to make sure there's more training. The Solidarity Fleet is coming on fine, you know, with between the government and KCCU. A number of fishermen, fisherfolk involved in it, so that it looks promising with fishing. And of course, people can sell to rainforest seafoods. So there are a lot of very positive things on the up. And with all the hotels being built, people are going to need fish to eat. The tourists are going to need fish. We are going to need more fish to eat, and so too the tourists. Selling a lot of conch, a lot of marine products, conch and fish. And of course, we have challenges with climate change. Global warming the seas, making it more difficult for us to get to lobster and conch. You know, with the divers, with the lobsters. There are lots of technical things to be done there to help more with the kind of lobster pots and so on and so forth. And so everybody had to work together, the government and the fisher folk. But it looks positive all around.
Great. Well, I'll let you enjoy it because I know you have to get some fish as well.
Yeah, well, I was looking for fish just now. All the fish out, they're done.
I'm sure they'll have some fish.
Yeah, I'm out there going to have more. But a lot of people buying fish.
Yes, and that's good. Thanks very much, Prime Minister. And we look forward to your presentation
as well.
Yes. So, yes, I see Mrs. Gonsalves here as well. And yes, it's turning out to be a beautiful afternoon here at the Calico playing field. And you can hear the excitement and the anticipation in the voices that we're speaking. And even in the chat is just behind us, there's a very, you know, passionate discussion happening in the back about the fishing that took place this year. And as you're seeing now, folks are clamoring in the back to get their share of fresh fish, and there's a non-stop flow of folks bringing their fish to get them clean, because there's a dedicated group in the back here. As you purchase your fish, you want it clean, you want it filleted, you want it your way, sliced, whichever way you want it, descaled, they do that for you, and they're doing that in the back here, great precision. And it is happening here at the Calico playing field. Many different things happening around us. The kids are having fun. The adults are what we say, liming in all of this as well on the sidelines. And it's generally a good environment for a family event. Food is on sale. As soon as you walk in, you can actually smell the food, and it's on sale. And a lot of fish dishes, fried shark and baked fish and stewed fish and all sorts of fish here at Calico playing field, and it's for you to enjoy. We can only tell you that much. We can only paint that picture for you, probably show you the visuals, but you have to come and experience it yourself. But if you really can't make it, we make sure that you have the best possible experience remotely, as we say. All right, we'll just get a little tight behind there, so we're going to head back on the outside and take in what's happening on the playing field. It might get a little loud, as we have, some speakers very loud on the outside there. DJ Roach is on the ones and twos. So we're having a closer look at some of the areas where you can purchase your fish. Some of the fish folk are here. And this looks like some red fish. Yes, some beautiful ones here. What types of fish do you have right now?
Red fish.
The red fish.
Snappers. And kobali.
Okay, and you weighed in already? You did your weigh-in already? Want to tell us your weight?
About 60 pounds.
Alright, good job. What was it like today out on the sea?
Not too rough, but the tide was hard though.
Okay, alright, with all the best. And you went out as well? You were out as well? What was that like out there?
Yeah, my day was okay. Yeah, I went trawling in the ocean. We trawled for tuna, kingfish, dolphin. But my day was successful also.
What time did you start this morning?
This morning I leave 5 o'clock this morning. Yeah.
And you came back when?
I came back 3:30.
Wow, so that's an entire day, well, in the sun.
It was all good.
All right, but how much did you catch? What was your weight like?
My weight was almost 300. Yeah.
And that's primarily cavalli?
Yes, sir.
What type of fish did you get most of?
I catch dolphin and cavalli.
Dolphin and cavalli. All right, well, all the best. All right, so that's a lot of dolphin and cavalli in that one. Quite a lot of redfish, I must add, this year. And yes, snapper, yes, red snapper. Pretty much very, very prominent here this afternoon. Yes. You guys went out today? Yes, right. So they... yes, of course. The excitement is here. The fish and folk are all smiles because their customers are coming, and this afternoon they're getting the full exposure. They're getting the full exposure they so deserve after a long day at sea today. We're just trying to get a closer view of what's happening here at the Calico playing field, and of course, we want to make sure that we get a good view for you. You were out on the sea today? You went out on the sea today? What was it like for you? What was your experience like?
Well, it could have been a little tough because fishermen can't find the fishermen. Well, it's been more than 100 pounds still.
Okay, alright. So, right. Mostly snapper?
Dolphin, tuna, cavalli.
Dolphin, tuna, cavalli. Alright, thanks very much. All the best. Great. So you see dolphin, tuna, cavalli, some of the more prominent names this afternoon as we skip through the stalls here, and we're trying to get a view. I think we have more of the snappers here, some very big fish here over here. Yes, of course, we're giving a snapshot as to what the stars look like. I know you're having your late lunch, but tell me, what was it like out there?
Very rough. It was a nice attack, obviously.
How much did you get? Well, all the best today.
Alright,
thanks. Alright, so you see, Red Snapper is a very popular one here this afternoon. As we're being drowned out by the sound system in the back there, so I'll just try to go away for a bit. There's a bit of a sprinkle on the outside here, so we're trying to not get drizzled in the process. But you can see the process, you can see the work that is involved. A fisherman just said he was out from since 5 this morning. He got back at 3:30 and he's been at it. He's been at it until 3:30. Quite a lot of work to be out there. Quite a lot of dedication required to do such. We just want to make sure that we move away from the sound system for a bit. But the ceremony is expected to get started soon. We welcome all of those who are listening on NBC Radio, those who are watching by way of BC3 Television, the Agency for Public Information, those channels, those Facebook pages. We say welcome to you. It is a beautiful, beautiful afternoon. Little sprinkle, as mentioned, but nothing to be alarmed about in terms of threatening rain, at least not at the moment. It's a great family atmosphere. It's still a family atmosphere. I can still smell the popcorn. I can see the Bunks and Castle in the distance rocking away, as the children are certainly enjoying their time there. But we hope that you would stay with us for the ceremony.
Thank you. We'll now move into a welcome and opening remarks by our Chief Fisheries Officer, Mrs. Jennifer Cruikshank Coward.
Good afternoon. I would like to welcome. Good afternoon to the Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Ralph E. Gonsalves, Prime Minister St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the Honorable Sobota Caesar, Minister of Agriculture, Forestry, Fisheries, Rural Transformation, Industry and Labor, other parliamentarians who are here with us this afternoon, the fisher folk, the media, the Fisherman's Day Committee. Good afternoon. Good afternoon and welcome to the closing and price-giving ceremony of the 46th anniversary of Fisherman's Day celebrations 2023. The theme for this year's activity is our livelihood, our industry. Let us protect it through the blue economy. And the slogan, make our future bright, fish right. It is my pleasure to be here today celebrating with the fisher folks of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. That is our fishermen, fish vendors, the management of fish establishment, seafood suppliers, and all those who are involved in the development of the blue economy. The Fisheries Division continues to focus on its mission, that is to manage and develop the fishery sector through the utilization of available aquatic resources by research, technology transfer, and training of our stakeholders. The development of the blue economy is being promoted through conservation, sustainable management, and the development of the fisheries sector. Taking into consideration that there are other sectors that are who also depend on the marine environment for economic livelihoods, such as the maritime industry, the tourism sector, just to mention a few. The marine environment has been providing opportunities for several industries, especially the fishing industry. Hence, the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry, Fisheries, Rural Transformation, Industry and Labor has identified a number of projects that are being implemented to assist the fishers, such as the placement of FADs in the waters of St. Vincent and Grenadines, capacity building of the fishermen through training in fishing techniques and safety at sea. It is imperative that we always emphasize the need for our fishers to exercise all the safety measures when they are at work. The Ministry of Agriculture continues to encourage a public and private sector partnership in this industry to explore the full potential of the marine space. More investments are needed for us to realize this potential so that we can have decent jobs, a better quality of life for the fisher folk and their families, as well as food security and nutrition for our nation. The Fishermen's Day Committee would like to thank the public for the support throughout the years, as this year has been another one. We would like to give a special shout out to the fishing community of Clare Valley and the Agriculture Input Warehouse, Kingston Fish Market, for recognizing the fishers who operate at their facilities, and the teachers and students of the Girls High School Social Science Department. Thank you. Congratulations to all those who participated in this year's activities, and especially the Fisherman of the Year and his crew. You did well. To you, the fishermen of St. Vincent, we appreciate your contribution to this nation in food security by making sure that fish is on our dishes. The Fisheries Division staff and the fisher folks who attended the planning meetings thank you. The Fisherman's Day Committee Chairman, Mr. Raoul Lewis, who cannot be here today, this afternoon. He has some transportation issues. And the Deputy Chairman, Mr. Winsbot Harry, the Ministry of Agriculture, and the staff of the Fisheries Division, we like to thank you for your support. I would like to end with this year's slogan, make our future bright, fish right. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Howard. Next, we'll have brief remarks by the Minister of Agriculture, Forestry, Fisheries, Rural Transformation, Industry and Labour, Honourable Saboto Caesar. Please welcome Minister Caesar.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Ralph Gonsalves, area representative for the constituency of East St. George, permanent secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry, Fisheries, Rural Transformation, Industry and Labour, Chief Fisheries Officer and her staff, the Fisherfolk organizations which are here, and let us give a special round of applause for the fishers of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The Organizing Committee for Fisherman's Day 2023, the schools that are here, the children, brothers and sisters, media, all, a blessed Fisherman's Day 2023. It is definitely an honor and a pleasure to be here this evening. And when I was journeying here, I remembered a promise that I made last year that Fisherman's Day 2023, I will be going out on the rough seas with the fishers. Well, when I listened to the weather announcement a few days ago, and I heard that there was going to be a system passing to the south of the island, I decided not to go to sea today. But to my surprise, I think it's the best weather we have ever had for Fisherman's Day activity, and to God be the glory. I want to commend, firstly, the fisherfolk of our country for the excellent work that they continue to do. When the seas are rough, when the sun is extremely hot, they are the ones who, from day to day, would brave the seas to ensure that we have fish to purchase at the different centers. And I want us to give the fisher folk a special round of applause for their hard work and dedication. Food security is of first importance. Fish must always be available. Fish must be affordable, and fish must always be accessible in our country. To develop any country, there are four simple tenets which must always honor. There must be a clear political will to do what is right. The laws must be in place to ensure that that political will is honored. You have to mobilize the resources, meaning you can't only talk, you have to go and get the money to implement the things that you're talking about. And the fourth one, but very important, is the implementation. And a very important point of departure, always, whenever you speak about the blue economy and you speak about the fisheries sector, you must always remember the Argyle International Airport. And I want to recognize the hard work of the Honorable Prime Minister in ensuring that we didn't only talk about the blue economy, but he worked in a very dedicated manner to ensure that we have the Argyle International Airport. It was since the opening of the Argyle International Airport that we have witnessed in this country an increase in the confidence of the investors, whether it be locally, regionally, or internationally, in the fisheries sector. Before the Argyle International Airport, you had persons, Ifin and Botian, want to know, should I invest in fisheries? Because if I purchase a boat and it goes out, I have a large catch, how do I get it out of the country? So we had the political will to build the Argyle International Airport, constructed it, and we made a very strategic move after opening the airport. We recognized from day one that the government, the state, it has a very important role in fisheries. But it is of first importance that we create an enabling environment for the private sector to partner with the state so that we can build the fisheries sector. And that strategic move that we made was when we advertised in the newspapers in this country, the fisheries centers across St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and we had the buy-in from locals working closely with regional and international entities to lease these centers and to operationalize them. It was upon that platform, the opening of the Argyle International Airport, the leasing of the centers, that we saw the coming to St. Vincent and the Grenadines of Rainforest Seafoods. And today, I am proud to stand here as the Minister of Fisheries to boast that throughout the entire OECS, we have the most and the best quality fisheries centers between the government and the private sector. So the political will was clear. The enabling environment was created. Persons started to invest. And it is very important that we appreciate this, that to have a functioning fisheries sector, we must have the proper laws and regulations in place. And during the course of this year, the rest of the year, we are going to go out through the different communities and speak to the fisher folk, the fishing organizations, because before the end of 2023, we want to make some significant amendments to the Fisheries Act. Because as the industry continues to evolve, we must also see an evolution in the rules and regulations governing the industry. importantly for the fisher folk is the ability to harness the resources in the blue economy. It's one thing to build the airport to create the opportunity to move the fish, to lease out the facilities so that persons can have an opportunity to purchase fish from the fisher folk for export and for local consumption. But the question is, how are we going to get more fish? And this government, we embarked on a fleet expansion program. First of all, we looked at expanding the number of pirogues that we have. And I am proud to announce today that the program that we have jointly with the Kingston Cooperative Credit Union, KCCU, is oversubscribed, and we have 130 pre-approved applicants. We have already delivered several boats, and as we speak, we have 5 companies sourcing pirogues to bring to the fisher folk in the country. And I want us to pay careful attention to this. It is important that these companies, that they do the work in sourcing the boats, because when you buy a boat and you want it repaired, these companies also are willing to stock the parts to repair these boats. And for the fleet expansion program, the government will be putting in 20% of the value of the pirogue. You will be asked to put in something. Some of the off-takers are willing to put in up to 2.5%. And when you sell them the fish, at the end of the program, when you finish paying back the KCCU, they will take back their money in fish. This program definitely is going to bring significant opportunities to many young persons, many young fishers throughout the country. And I want to encourage those who have applied, been approved, and will be getting their boats to do what is honest and what is right. The government gave you the support. KCCU came on board. There are insurance companies also coming on board, because we have to insure the boats in order to make the fisher bankable. We have to insure the boats. And the government made the decision that in areas where these boats will be stored, that we will be hiring watchmen day and night, so that when you leave your boat there and your engine, the insurance company could be happy, KCCU could be happy, and you can go home feeling happy knowing that someone is watching your boat. Presently, we also have 10 engines to be dispersed through the KCCU program and initiative. And I had the opportunity last week to visit Cuba, where I spoke to several entities where they are willing to provide the technical support and training for persons who want to be engaged in fishing, whether you're using a pirogue or you will be participating on the Solidarity Fleet Expansion Program. And we are going to witness during the course of this year the birth of the first locally owned and managed tuna fleet here in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And sometimes when I speak to the applicants, they say to me, I want the process to move faster. I say, yes. KCCU last week approved the loans for the first two tuna vessels. That is significant. But importantly, in a conversation with the AG's chambers and the fisheries department, we have to put in place the required legal framework so that we will not offend the international laws. Because you don't just purchase the vessels, have an indigenous fleet, and go fishing for tuna, not remembering that you have international legal obligations. In St. Vincent and the Grenadines, as it relates to the fishery sector, we are protecting from the ridges to our reefs. And that is why we place a total ban in this country on the use of all glyphosate products. We put a total ban on aerial spraying. For the purposes of conservation, we ensured that there is now a maximum size lobster that you cannot take from our seas, because we want those larger size lobsters to remain to reproduce. We have a total ban on the capturing of turtles. We have a total ban on the capturing of the parrotfish. No shark finning is allowed in this country. And importantly, with the work of the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Environmental Fund, working closely with the Blue Marine Foundation and the technicians in the ministry, we are going to look at certain conservation methods over the next 6 months in this country because of a study which was just completed by the Blue Marine Foundation. I am getting the calls at the ministry that while we are happy that we are exporting large quantities of conch, that we have to ensure that generations to come, they will have conch as well. And we are going to have a national consultation on whether or not we are going to put a season on the capturing of conch. There's also a need for several rest areas to be put in place. And we have discussed over the years the issue of the implementation of regulations for bait fish. No bottom trawling will be allowed. And I want to thank the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Environmental Fund for sponsoring the Fisher Folk organization. And I know that the president is here, and I hope that he's listening, because we are here to support all Fisher Folk organizations. The Digi Fish equipment would be attached to some 30 boats, so that when the fisher folk, when you go out and you have this equipment in your boat, you can be tracked by satellite. And this whole issue, sometimes a fisherman goes out, when he's way out, he can't use his cell phone. And you hear on the news, another one of our brothers has gone missing. This is here to assist that. And I want to say to the donors that in the budget for 2024, we are going to ensure that the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, we also provide, through the fleet expansion program, the requisite instruments as well to complement the DigiFish equipment, and we will be purchasing some DigiFish instruments as well. We have to do more work as it pertains to the reef fish management. And before the end of this year, working with the technicians in fisheries, working with the tourism and hospitality sector and the operators of the yachts, we are going to put in place several no discharge areas. It is very important also that we don't only put the regulations on paper, but we put the proper monitoring systems in place, because there are many persons who are fishing for conch and they're taking the conch out of the shell and they're throwing the empty shell into the water. And it has been said to us, was told to us, that it is scientifically proven that this will reduce the conch population. And this is something that we are going to ensure that we regulate on paper and that we also monitor. I want to, in closing, encourage the young people in the country to get involved in fishing. There are many opportunities there for all of us. The markets are there. The environment, from a financial standpoint, is ripe for investment. Go to KCCU, ask for information on the program, whether it's the pirogue program or the tuna fleet expansion program, and get on board. I know that once we work together and that we do so in a sustainable manner, that we will have an excellent fisheries sector here in this country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minister Caesar, for your remarks. Now we'll have the Honorable Camille Gonsalves, Minister of Finance, Economic Planning and Information Technology, and a representative of Calico, also gracing us with some brief remarks. Minister.
Good afternoon. It's my pleasure, as always, to welcome so many people to Calequa, the home in the past, the home in the present, and the home in the future of Fisherman's Day in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I want us to celebrate, as we always do, the contributions of fisherfolk to the lives of Vincentians, to the livelihoods of the fisherfolk and their families, and to the economy of St. Vincent and the Grenadines as a whole. We have recognized in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, we've recognized in the government that a big part of our future, a big part of our advancement, is what Saboto calls the blue economy. It's about investing more and more money into fisheries and fisherfolk. It's about sustainably utilizing the resources that God has given us in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And we have decided, and we have put our money where our mouth is, that we will continue to invest in the advancement of fishing, of fisheries, and of fisherfolk anywhere they can be found in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We realize that we have gone through a few difficult cycles in fisheries. The eruption of the La Soufre volcano affected fisheries up and down both the windward and leeward coast of this country. We recognize that fisher folk in the north of the country were displaced, and many of them ended up in shelters, many of them in the Caliqua Anglican School, and they had to become Caliqua fishermen for a very lengthy period of time because they couldn't go back home. And we recognize the anecdotal evidence that the movement of ash down the windward coast affected the fishing grounds of fisher folk, particularly those who fish lobster. And we recognize also that the challenges of inflation, the global challenges in the price of fuel, the challenges related to COVID and exporting products, all affected fisher folk negatively in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And we in the government have decided to stand with you, to support you, to hold you up, and to make sure that you advance, because as the fisher folk of St. Vincent and the Grenadines advance, so too does the economy of St. Vincent and the Grenadines advance. We didn't have, the last Fisherman's Day, we didn't have speeches. But the time before, I stood here and told you that a new fish exporter would be established in Caliqua called Rainforest Seafood. And people said, that is old talk. But there it is. Right across from the fish market where I buy my fish, and right across from Dean where I eat my fish, there is Rainforest Seafood that's employing over 100 Vincentians, that's providing direct livelihoods to over 150 fisher folk, and is exporting fish monthly, proudly bearing the flag of St. Vincent and the Grenadines all around the world. Enriching conch fishermen in Union Island, and tuna fishermen from Oya, and lobster fishers from Caliqua, and snapper fishers from Clay Valley. All of them are getting a decent wage and a decent living from this new player in the market. And we salute them today for the work they have done, and also for the engine. Is it the engine? This one over here. It's a rainforest on it. The engine that you're providing to the fisher folk as a prize today. We are here now, as I promised then, this new purchaser and exporter would come. We are here now to say that there will be further advancements in fisheries in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Saboto mentioned something called the Solidarity Fishing Fleet. What we are going to do, the government is going to buy advanced fishing vessels, not the regular pirogues. And we are going to have people who know how to operate these advanced fishing vessels. And they are going to train young people in modern fishing techniques. Not go out in the morning and come back by lunchtime, but modern, long-lasting fishing techniques. Not on the reefs, but deep in our territorial waters, to show new ways to fish and earn a living and make money in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And the Solidarity Fishing Fleet will be rolling out this year, before this year is complete. Additionally, Saboto is continuing the important work of helping to provide boats and engines to fisher folk who need them. And he has a long list of people who have applied, and scores of fishermen and fisherwomen will have boats and engines courtesy of this government, who will be bankrolling and supporting the loans that you take out to get this important equipment. We have come around and donated safety gear, wire to build lobster pots, all sorts of different equipment, buoys, nets, to ensure that the fisher folk are well equipped. Life jackets, well, safety equipment generally, to ensure that they're well equipped, that they're safe, and that they're productive. And we will continue to invest in the fisher folk of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, because we believe strongly, very strongly, that we have abundant waters, that we have talented fisher folk and that the fish in our abundant waters will help us to feed ourselves and to grow our economy as well. A few months ago, before dredging activity began off Brighton, we had consultations here with the fisher folk to understand and explain precisely where the dredging activity was supposed to take place. And when there was some confusion, we provided the Coast Guard to take the fisher folk precisely to the location where the dredging was going to take place. And we provided the information about the bathymetric studies. We provided underwater footage to show that there was no reef, there was no seagrass, there was no fish population resident in the area, to explain to fisher folk what we were going to do. But some fishers said that nonetheless, the presence of the boat in the area would affect some of the work that they do, transiting up and down Argyle Stubbs Fishing Bay area. So we have compiled a list. People in Calicoa have helped provide the list, people in Fishing Bay, people elsewhere, of all the fisher folk that we're aware of. And I want to thank the fisheries, all of the fisheries officers for this. All of the fisher folk that we are aware of who ply their trade up and down that coast, coming out of Calicoa and Fishing Bay. And each one of them, when we made our settlement with the people who are dredging the area, we said, yes, you have to pay for the resource, but you have to pay for the time of the fisher folk who have been displaced from that area while you're dredging. And each one of those fisher folk, I believe the list is now approaching 100 fisher folk, each one of them will receive a measure of compensation for the displacement and the inconvenience that they endured while that dredging activity was going on. And you'll hear more announcements about that from either the Minister of Fisheries or the Prime Minister himself. Because again, we always place the interests of the fisher folk front and center. We believe that in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, we are on the cusp of a new era in terms of profit and livelihoods and expansion in the area of fisheries. We believe that our fisher folk will lead us forward into this era of the blue economy. We believe that we have the talent and the skill and the know-how to get this expansion completed. And we believe that we as the government have done the talking, we've done the consulting, we've done the listening, we've done the planning, and it's time for us to put our money where our mouth is. And you will see, rolling out this year into next year, a raft of new initiatives to support fisher folk and their livelihoods and their contribution to the economy of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. When there's a war in Ukraine, wheat might get expensive, beef might get expensive, chicken might get expensive, but the war in Ukraine can't affect the snapper and the tuna and the lobster in the waters of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And we are going to make ourselves sufficient, self-sufficient in providing protein to ourselves, whether it's pork, whether it's chicken, or whether it's fish and lobster. And the government is going to play an integral role in making sure that we feed ourselves, that we feed our tourists, and that we grow our economy. And that's what Fisherman's Day is all about. We celebrate you because we cannot do it without you. And if you love your fish, and if you love your fisher folk, and if you love St. Vincent and the Grenadines, understand that we are on the cusp of a new era in this blue economy. And I want all of us to embrace it. Fisher folk of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I salute you, I love you, and I want you to know that this government is there for you every step of the way as you try to grow your business and advance yourself and help us to grow St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Thank you very much. We'll be right back.
Thank you, Minister Gonsalves. The next voice you hear will be that of our Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. the Honorable Ralph Gonsalves, as he delivers our feature address for us this evening.
I get wings to fly. Oh, I'm a
Comrade Chairman, Saboto Camilo Curtis, other members of Parliament here present, the Chief Fisheries Officer and her team at the Ministry of Fisheries, specially invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, and the boys and girls who are having a wonderful time at the Bunks and Castle and all about. It's a wonderful family day here at Kaliakwa. And those who are listening on radio and not here yet, come along. We're going to be here for a few more hours yet, enjoying ourselves and celebrating with the fisher folk. Remember our theme. Our livelihood, our industry, let us protect it through the blue economy. Notice the elements. It's our livelihood, it's our industry, and protect it through the blue economy. And the slogan is, make our future bright, fish right. In other words, the centrality of fishing and fisher folk to our livelihoods, to our economy, and to the sustenance of our civilization. I want to recognize somewhere in the audience, I have not seen him, the Vice Minister of the State of Palestine, Vice Minister in Foreign Affairs for the State of Palestine. He should be here with one or more members of his team, just to indicate that they are here with 10 professionals, 10 doctors, one nurse, 11 professionals working at the hospital in the area of orthopedics for the week here. That's to deal with their bones. Ophthalmology to deal with your eyes, general surgery, and pediatrics, that is to say, to deal with children. And they are doing a lot of operations. I'm told that they will do in excess of 60 operations in the week, and a lot of consultations. And on Saturday, a team headed by Dr. Hiren Patel. All of this is done for free. He's a young professor from Harvard University, and he brought a team here, and they did a dozen or so brain surgeries, all top of the line, free, and dozens of consultations. And of course, we have permanent medical missions. The most important one being the World Pediatric Project, and of course, the permanent Cuban medical mission. I mention these having recognized our friends from the State of Palestine to begin to put a marker down for something to which I will refer. Whatever we do here with fisheries, whatever the matters touching and concerning the blue economy, a number of other important institutions are vital for the success of what we do in fisheries, including hospital services, including education, including maritime administration, including the credit union movement, the regulation of banks and insurance companies, the condition of our parliamentary democracy, our legal systems, all of them are connected. What's happening with the national lottery? How are we developing it? The national lottery, for instance, contribute $30,000 for today, Fisherman's Day. And if they were not properly organized, they would not have been able to make this contribution here, and as they make it to sports and culture and education and the like. So I want all of those things to be borne in mind. And I will come back to some of them. But I want to give you some facts to support what Camilo and Sobota were talking about, the importance and the growth of the fishing industry. We didn't have we had a difficult period in COVID and during the volcanic eruptions. But I want to say this to you. In the year 2022, last year, 3.2 million pounds of fish were landed and marketed in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I want you to get that number in your head. Last year, 3.2 million pounds of fish, including the conch, were landed and marketed in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I want that number to sink in. And the value of what was landed, the fish sales from the local market, amounted to almost $22 million. Those are the numbers. Over 3 million pounds of fish, including conch and lobster, were landed last year with a value of almost $22 million. That is, in fish landings, 15% more than 2021. And the value, 30% more than in 2021. So you see, last year, the fishing industry is growing both in volume and in value. These things don't happen by accident. They happen with the work of the Ministry of Fisheries, with the government, with other institutions, and importantly, with the efforts of the fisher folk themselves. And then, you may ask the question, well, Comrade Ralph, the first 3 months of the year, first quarter, how things looking up in 2023? Well, I will give you those numbers, because I have them. From January to March, from the 1st of January to the 31st of March this year, over 760,000 pounds of fish were landed in the first 3 months of this year. with an estimated market value of nearly $6 million. That's in the, remember every year, have four quarters, you know. And that is one quarter. So we are on target, all things being equal, of improving on what we did last year. Because already, for the first quarter, the landings increased by over 8% and the value by over 21% compared to the first 3 months last year. I'm giving you the information, the data, to support the words that you heard from Saboto and from Camilo. Now, how are we doing with the particular species of fish? The most important one from a singular basis is conch. Roughly one third is from conch. And the conch fisher folk have been doing quite well. But there are other species of great importance, and the fishermen know this. Jacks, yellowfin tuna, barracuda, dolphin, mahi-mahi, and lobster. In 2022, last year, we see a lot of increase in robin and jacks and barracuda. In fact, for robin and jacks, twice the robin and jacks were landed last year as landed in 2021, during the year of suffering. But we have to watch yellowfin tuna, dolphin, and lobster because we see some decreases. And all that has to be examined as to all the reasons. Some of them proffered by Saboto and Camilo. But some of it also has to do, especially with the lobster, not only suffering, but also climate change. Because people have to dive deeper in order to get the lobster, because the seas are getting warmer. And the lobsters are going to cooler places. So I think that is an area where the fisher folk and the fisheries division have to address. In addition to the technical matters which Saboto and Camilo spoke about regarding the fish pot stem and all the technical aspects of dealing with the harvesting of lobsters. I will tell you this. No government in the history of St. Vincent and the Grenadines has put as much money and effort into fishing like the government, which I have the honor to lead. There are some things which people forget. And we have been doing this day by day, as the evangelists them say, day by day, sweet Jesus. And we are making progress, and you know it. There was established under the previous government a fish market. But the fish market was, in tongue, was inadequate for the purpose. We got the Japanese to improve there and spend $16 million modernizing that plant down there in Kingston. $16 million. Then they say, up in Owea, we have a lot of fishermen. That the fishermen them in Owea, they had to go elsewhere to land and move, land the fish and move their boats. And we ask the question, why can't we build a fishing facility and a jetty, a wharf up in Owea? People say we crazy. Just like how they say we crazy to build a bridge over Rabuka and build the Argyle International Airport, or to do the education revolution, or the medical modern medical and diagnostic complex at Georgetown, or the port where we're building. Everything you try, no, naysayers. But you all know that I am one man. I don't bother upon naysayers. Once I know something is good for the country, no set of noise that a handful of people make could stop me. You hear me? All you don't know that already with me. I come and explain it to you. You say yes. The majority of you say yes. I write it in a manifesto. And you vote me, I'm doing it. I ain't bothering with nice makers who want to take me off course. Never will I allow that. And we got $30-something million from the Japanese. And we build a wharf up at Owea. We build a complex up there. And one of the things, what we said to people, not only would it help the fishermen up there, but just in case there is a natural disaster and we have to take some people out by boat, we could carry the Coast Guard vessel and other boats up there and take people from there to safety, which is what happened when Sufri blew. You see vision? Eh? You have to see wrong corner, you know. You have to see wrong corner. Unless you see wrong corner, you can't lead. No. Then we are fixing up the fishing facilities. This one here at Kalakwa. I will tell you, the chief fisheries officer, who is my very good friend, when we finish fix it up, and the people who are fixing up take too long, even the money was there and everything, but they eventually fix it up well. And after they fix it up, the place still lock up. Me ask, where you locking it up for? So don't believe, on a daily basis, we are inquiring what is happening to the condition of the fisher folk. When we're going to build the port, they say, how are you going to do that? The number of people who got some dwellings on the beach. What about the fisher folk them there? And some fellas start to kick up. Kick up, you know. They ain't know what I mean yet. They're kicking up. But this government always make sure that we take care of the people if we're displacing you anywhere. Always. We built 49 houses at Lowmans. A beautiful site. 49. One bedroom, two bedroom, and three bedroom house. The cost of what they had done at the bay was under $300,000. That was the value. but we build for the people on the beach. $4.8 million worth of houses and give them the key for nothing. You hear me? And every man and woman who is involved with any boat or anything down there, get compensation. Ask me, brethren, Winsworth, Harry. And you go tell you. Ask me, brethren, Winsworth. And he go tell you how we fix them up, including he fixing them up nice, nice, nice. All of them. They were saying, some of them, no, they don't want to go low, man's. They want a high-rise building down a bottom tongue. You bring coconut, give me, girl. Oh, Sabi, you bring it, me. You love Sabi. I want you cut. I thought you only love good-looking man. I want you cut, girl. Thank you. This beautiful lady make a mistake, you know. I want to thank you for the coconut water. But if you help me choke, you're going to make me talk longer. Yes. No. The people came to me. They say, we ain't tell nobody we want to be in any high-rise building. They say, we want our own house. With our own porch. With our own little place in front and behind where we could plant flowers. They want a kitchen garden. Which is what happened. And those who are at Pole Yard, I want you to hear me. I'm going to fix you up the same way when I move you from Pole Yard. You can put your pot on the fire. I'm fixing plenty road. But the only place in the world that you ain't got no road which one fix is the heavenly highway. In heaven, that's the only place around Celestial Avenue. That's the only place where you ain't got road in one fix, Celestial Avenue. Celestial Avenue is the only place. Go England, go America, go Barbados. When we go to Beulah Land, we will meet no problems. But right now, we have a lot of challenges to deal with. And you ain't taking me off my message here today, comrade. I know you know, and I love you, but you ain't taking me off of my message today. God bless you. Now, we are fixing up all the fisheries centers. And right now, there's a big project going on at Barley in relation to the center to deal with whaling. That's taking place right now in Barley to deal with blackfish. I say whaling because it's a species of whale. Not the whale like the one in Beckery, but it's a species of whale still. And we are taking care of all of these things. And the fishermen, children, and grandchildren, and great-grandchildren, any one of them who want to go to university, they're inside a university. And plenty of them are inside a university. All of them are inside the children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren inside a secondary school. And 75% of them who go to secondary school end up at community college. But I'm saying we have to have young enterprising Vincentians, some of them who got fish in the blood, to stay in the fishing industry. It's a big area of study and activity, and a lot of money is there for it. And more money is going to be there because of the way we are transforming this economy. We're bringing more and more tourists to St. Vincent because we're building more and more hotels. And you're having more and more restaurants. And people who come here, like Vincentians, would want to eat fish. They want to eat conch. And they want to have lobster. That's the reality. Sandals is going to be finished by the end of the year. They're opening in the first quarter of next year. Nearly 1,200 persons going to be working there. By the way, when the hotel was starting down there for the first time, You can't see the hotel opening. You sure somebody not spitting in your mouth or break stick in your ears? Somebody ain't spitting in your mouth or break stick in your ears? No. You can't see hotel building and opening and you say so. In the book of Proverbs, in the Psalms, and our grandparents told us, listen not to lying tongues, believe what you see with your eyes, and the truthful reportage what you see with your eyes. That is what you deal with. You hear me? Now, one of the differences why some of them want me leave, you know. My tongue sharp like razor, and I take on all of them. All of them. Because I'm an ancient warrior. And my back broad. You could bust me head, but you can't addle me brains. No. By the end of 2026, we should have an additional 1,000 or 1,200 first-class hotel rooms in this country. That is going to mean several thousands of tourists on an organized, on an ongoing basis, wanting fish, wanting conch, wanting lobster, wanting fruits, wanting vegetables, wanting ground provisions, wanting persons who go into secondary school and community college and university to be employed. And I want to tell you this, nowhere at all in St. Vincent and the Grenadines since independence that you see as much activity, economic activity, as today in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, both by the government and the private sector. I see a man like McDowell who make money in Caribbean glass. We know his skill there. And he decide that the economy is moving into tourism services, among other things. The man taking money and he build out by Junction, Maya Suites, a beautiful hotel. Instead of somebody crab in the barrel, keep them all shut. They're trying to pull along the man how you could build a hotel like that there, so. I don't know what happened to some of you, you know. Nobody, they don't like themselves. They don't like St. Vincent. They want to pull it down. Everything you do, they want to pull it down. They want to stop us from building the airport, I build it. They want to stop us from building Rabaka Bridge, I build it. They want to stop the education revolution, I put it in place. The health revolution, the port, every single thing for progress, it will be done under the Unity Labour Party government. And if you wait in on me, wait for me at the end of 2025, and you're going to meet me in the election, on election day. You hear me? And that is where the people are being heard. That is where they're being heard. Now, I tell you this. We saw very clearly when we came to office, and I've spoken to you about this already, that the age of preferences for sugar, for arrowroot, for bananas, those days, preferences in the marketplace, those days come to an end. Those days come to an end. Why are you so ignorant and stupid, boy? Why are you so ignorant and stupid? You eat your school fee? You ain't following what happening. You don't follow what happening in Europe. Eh? You don't find what happening in Europe? The point is this. Yeah. You want some attention? I give him attention so that the people will put him under manners. That's why I give some attention. That's the end of you know. We saw that the banana preferences were going. So we had to try and direct the economy in other ways. Agriculture in a different way, in fruits and vegetables, in ground provisions, greenhouses. Build it in a different way while we still grow some bananas. But we had to direct it in other services. And the services among the areas is tourism. And we have to do it in fisheries because we have a lot more sea space than land space in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Let me tell you this. St. Vincent has 150 square miles of land space. And we have over 11,000 square miles of sea space. You hear me? We have our 12-mile exclusive. We have our 12-mile territorial sea and contiguous zone. And we have 200 miles of exclusive economic zone. And beyond that is the high seas. And in order for us to patrol our exclusive economic zone, I buy more Coast Guard vessel, including a $20 million offshore patrol vessel, which can stay out for 7 days and to help the fishermen themselves when they go into our exclusive economic zone. You see how everything is held together, my brothers and sisters, my comrades, my fellow Vincentians, whom I love dearly. You see how it happens? That is how it is being done. You have to pull everything together. No, you take the issue of the Solidarity fishing fleet. The Solidarity fishing fleet is worked out with the Kingston Cooperative Credit Union. Under this government, we have encouraged the credit union movement, and it has grown, and it has consolidated. Smaller credit unions join the bigger ones. The biggest credit union in this country is GECU, the Government Employees Cooperative Credit Union. It has assets in excess of $340 million. Assets bigger than some commercial banks in this country. Then you have the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Teachers Cooperative Credit Union in excess of $160 million in assets. And the Kingston Cooperative Credit Union growing very well, in excess of $140 million in assets. In fact, so big, KCCU is becoming that we just agreed to sell them a parcel of land up in Georgetown where they want to invest over $10 million in a headquarters up there. That is what is happening with the credit union. And we put proper regulation in place to facilitate the growth of these credit unions. That is what we have been doing with the credit union movement, as we do with National Lottery, as we do with Maritime Administration. Now you hear me talk all the time about people who all they're interested in, and I come back to this all the time, all they're interested in is to pull down St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Why? Why they want that to happen? Why they want that to happen? It's not because the borough, it's not because St. Vincent and the Grenadines they're interested in. They're interested in power. They're hungry for power. But they have no ideas. No ideas at all. Some of them are internet crazies. They're hoping to move from the status of internet crazy to your excellency to want to be ambassador and all the rest of it. But you got far more internet crazies competing for a handful of jobs for ambassador. So they're bound to be dissatisfied. You know, I tell you this. We have been in office since 2001. Right now in this country, there is no carpenter, mason, tileman, electrician, plumber, general agricultural worker who want work and can't get work. You have more people employed in St. Vincent and the Grenadines today and registered at the NIS than at any time in the history of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Those are the facts. You hear me? And all around you, you see the progress. You see the houses, the beautiful houses the fishermen and fisherwomen building. You watch the housing stock from fancy in the northeast to down at Richmond, down in the northwest, from Kingston to Campbell in Union Island. The housing stock has increased by over 70% since 2001, including fisher folk and beautiful houses. Look around here. Look around here how they're growing up all over. Long ago, when you pass Prospect and you go in country, it's only in between you see one or two nice houses. Now, almost every single house is a beautiful house. Because of the money which is spinning in the country. Because of all the activity which we're encouraging. And you have recognized that. And that is why every single time we go to the polls, 2001, 2005, 2010, 2015, 2020, you say yes to the comrade, yes to the Unity Labour Party. And at the end of 2025, when the next election is called, you will also say yes to the comrade and the Unity Labour Party, because progress is here happening before your very eyes. And inside of that, the fishermen, the fisherfolk, making good money, and you have better money to get. Don't pay any attention to the lying tongues of those who want to replace the comrade. Look at your own eyes. See what you see. See the progress that you see. In housing, in water, in electricity, in airports, in seaports, in hospitals and clinics. You look at the education revolution, you look at everything we're happening in this country, and you see tremendous progress. And what is happening with the fisher folk is part of that progress. Long live the efforts of the fishermen and the fisherwomen, the fisher folk of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Long live the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. I love you. I am there for you in every season. I will never fail you. Thank you, and God bless you.
Invite our Chief Fisheries Officer, Mrs. Jennifer Cruikshank-Howard, to announce the winners of today's activities.
Good evening once again. So I have been given the task to announce the winners for today's competition. And we will go right into it because we know it's getting late. And we will just make the announcements. Then we will do our vote of thanks. And we'll have some entertainment right after that. So let me give you a summary of today's competition. We had 108 fishers that were registered with us. We had 38 boats. Out of the 38 boats that went out to sea today, 22 boats returned. We had the first boat that returned. There was a breakdown, and he was being brought in by the Coast Guard. We also had a second incident of another boat that broke down. Anyways, all in all, the weather conditions today, it was sunny. The seas were calm, according to the fishers. And it was a good day for fishing. So for today, we had a total catch of 3,655.03 pounds of fish. Today's catch, 3,655.03 pounds of fish. And this is one of our better years. The average weight per boat for today was 166.14 pounds. That's the weight average pound per boat. Yes, that is a good average. Okay, so in the week, we had a focus on Clare Valley. And there was a robot competition there. You remember when I gave the welcome remarks earlier, I spoke about the village of Clare Valley. So we had a fishing competition there, and we had three winners. We had the third heaviest catch, Donald Bruce. He brought in 13.3 pounds. The second heaviest catch we had Colin Gordon, 16.2 pounds. And the first heaviest catch, we had Eustace Bruce, and he brought in 23.7 pounds. These prices will be collected at the Fisheries Division's office anytime from tomorrow. So, for today. Okay, I was just informed by the minister that you can come tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock, and we will have the official handing over of the... But let me just call the winners so that you will know who can come tomorrow. So for today's competition for Class 4, we had one person who entered, and the heaviest catch, well, it is the only boat. The name of the captain is David Brown. That's one of my favorite fisher. For the boat, the name of the boat is Sea Hunter, and he caught 18.5 pounds of fish. And this category, this class, is for those boats that are they do fishing commercially, but it is a smaller class, and they use very small engines. Some of them just rowboats. So we didn't have anybody entering the competition for Class 3. That's the sport fisher. And we have noticed for the last couple of years, we're not having any sport fisher. So everybody is commercial now, so we may have to make a decision next year not to have the Class 3 competition. Next year will be the last year. I was just informed. Okay, so for today's competition for Class 2, we had three different categories, and we had three different prices. So we had a third heaviest catch in Class 2. The name of the captain for that boat is Swan Lucas. The name of the boat is Eternal, and he brought in 8.5 pounds of fish. The second heaviest catch for the singlest heaviest fish, we had Julian Bratcher, and the name of the boat is Sharko, and the weight was 13.2 pounds. For the first heaviest single fish, we had Barney Wright, and the name of the boat is Water Life, and he brought in, that single heaviest fish came 18.05 pounds. The other category was for the largest number of fish, and we had Sean Bratcher, the third largest number of fish. The name of the boat is Bounce Back, and he had 112 heads of fish. And the second largest number, we had Julian Bratcher, the name of his boat, Sharko, and he had 168 heads. And the first largest number of fish, Alan Brooker, and his boat is Bung the Way. He brought in 218 heads of fish. We had the third heaviest catch in that Class 2 competition. Again, we had Suhan Lucas, the name of the captain of the boat. He came third in this category, in this class, and the name of the boat is Itano. He landed 134.5 pounds of fish. We had the second heaviest catch, Barney Wright, and the name of the boat, Water Life. He brought 171.23 pounds of fish, and the heaviest catch for that class, it's Julian Bratcher with the boat, Sharko, and he brought 228 pounds of fish. If Mr. Bratcher is around, Mr. Bratcher won a 15 horsepower engine, and you can collect that tonight. For the Class 2. Yeah. So if Mr. Julian Bratcher is here, you can come forward and collect your engine, sir. Okay, so we move right into Class. Oh, he's here. Congratulations to you, Mr. Bratcher, to you and your crew. I know it was you and your boys.
Minister?
Yes, so congratulations to you, Mr. Bratcher, for winning the first heaviest, the first heaviest catch. Yeah. Congratulations to you and your crew. And we want to thank you for entering the competition. Again, you have been entering this competition over the years. And we want to ask you to continue to be with us in the industry and also to help us to promote the industry. Okay, so for class one, we go right into it. Okay, so in class one, for the second heaviest single fish, for the category, category for the heaviest single fish, we had a tie. So instead of we have first, second, and third place, we had just first and second place because there was a tie. So for the second place, for the heaviest single fish, we had Julian Fabian and Dennis Gibson. Julian Fabian with the boat Forces, he had a catch of 16.5. Also Dennis Gibson with the boat Watch It had a cut, the largest single fish, 16.5 pounds. For the heaviest single fish, we had Davian Muckett from Clare Valley with the boat Defender, and he brought in an Ocean Gar, and it weighed 42.75 pounds. For the other category, the third largest number of fish, for the third place, we had Calvert Thomas with the boat Conscious Family, and he brought in 376 heads of fish. For the second largest number of fish, we had Ruben Bratcher from the boat Aquaholic, and that was 412 heads. For the largest number of fish, we had Timothy Murphy, and the name of the boat is Flawless, and the number of fish was 442 heads. For the third heaviest catch, that's the other category, we had the third heaviest catch, we had Ruben Bratcher from the boat Aquaholic, and he brought in 333.95 pounds of fish. For the second heaviest catch, we had Timothy Murphy with the boat Flawless, and he brought in 367.85 pounds of fish. And for the fisherman of the year, the boat that brought in the heaviest catch, the name of the captain is Davian Muckett of Clare Valley. The name of the boat is Defender, and the catch that he brought in total 644.81 pounds. We want to congratulate Mr. Davian Muckett of Clare Valley. Mr. Muckett, I hope you are wrong to come and collect your prize. And this engine was donated by Rainforest Seafood. We have Rainforest Seafood on board with us. Last year, they donated a 75 horsepower two-stroke outboard engine, and they have repeated it this year. We are hoping that Rainforest Seafood will continue to support the fishers of St. Vincent and the Grenadines with their donation. Mr. Davian Muckett. Is Mr. Muckett here? Mr. Muckett and your crew, can you come forward? Clare Valley, fisherfolk. Mr. Muckett, are you around? All right, well, you can come to the Fisheries Division tomorrow. We will have the ceremony at 9 o'clock, and we will ask Mr. Seymour, Stephen Seymour from Rainforest Seafood, to be present to hand over the engine to Mr. Muckett. And we want to thank you, the fisher folk. We're going to have another member of staff who is going to give us the vote of thanks for today.
Thank you, Chief. And the results will be given to the media houses, so you will check us for that, please. And to give us a vote of thanks for this evening is Fisheries Officer Alisa Martin.
Protocol has already been established. The Fisherman's Day Committee salutes all Fisher Folk in St. Vincent and the Grenadines for their hard work and contribution towards nation building and economic growth. The Fisherman's Day Committee extends sincere gratitude to all companies and individuals who helped to make the Fisherman's Day 2023 a success. Special thanks to the chairman of the Fisherman's Day Committee, Mr. Raul Lewis, for his commitment and hard work and leadership within the fishing industry. The committee also wishes to give special thanks to the Honorable Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, for his featured speech. The Honorable Minister Saboto Caesar, Minister of Agriculture, Forestry, Fisheries, Rural Transformation, Industry and Labor for his brief remarks. We'll also like to thank Honorable Camilo Gonsalves, Minister of Finance, Economic Planning and Information Technology for his brief remarks also. And he's also the representative of Kaliakua. We'll also like to thank the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Mr. Joe Doblin, for the opening prayer to open today's ceremonies, the Fisherman's Day Committee, the staff of the Fisheries Division, the National Lotteries Authority, St. Vincent Breweries Limited, the Caribbean Fisheries Mechanism, C. Prescott and Sons, Rainforest Seafood SVG Limited, the Carnival Development Committee, Howard's Marine, Agriculture Import Warehouse, Kingstown Fish Market, the Fishery, the Forestry Division, the SVG Coast Guard, the SVG Police Force. All fishers, and would like to congratulate all the winners of today's event. The Calico Tongue Board, Barrelly Fisheries Development Cooperative, Goodwill Fishermen's Cooperative, the National Fisher Folk Organization, Anna's Cakes and Catering, Calico Fisheries Center, DJ Black Eyes, and I'd like to thank in advance Mr. Hans John for the entertainment he'll present at the end of my presentation. The media houses, and we'll also like to thank you, the general public, for attending. I want to wish you a good evening and encourage you to get home safely.
PM. Good evening. If you're ready to have a good time, somebody just show me your right hand, please. Just show me your right hand. Pull up, DJ. Pull up, man. Pull up, man. Play me low. I want you to give all the fishermen here a round of applause this evening for me, please. Let me give them a round of applause. Let me give them a round of applause, now, man. And let me give them some blessings. For them alone, them would take me life, stop me from living. But give thanks for life, this life, cause this life is worth living. I see success, progress, constant blessing. Cause who God bless, no one curse, no, cause we blessing. Hey, cause who God bless, no one curse, no, cause we blessing. Yes, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing. Let me see some lighters. Drink them high, I say. Hands up. Push them up, I say. You ready again? We getting warm. Calico, we gonna start it now. Ready? We getting warm. For the love of God. Oy, oy, oy. Sing it out. His music dung in deep on the eye. It drives the feeling so contagious. Them judges really have it hard. Oy. Them fans really come out. I said they come out to play now. I hear it now. I hear it now. I hear it now. It's like bumping. I hear it now. If you're proud to come from St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I want everybody to sing it out, sing it out. I talk about Zion Hill. I talk about Symphony. Whoa! I talk about Zion. Everybody play. Watch me. Sing when you're hearing. Sing when you're hearing. We're getting warm when you're hearing. Listen. Oh Lord, from the Panyard to Victoria Park, the bands them lining up to play now. Supporters come from near and far, yeah. This here is only love and vibe, yeah.
I hear in a tenor beating, a guitar playing. I hear in a bassline pumping.
Who talking about?
I hear in a tenor beating, a guitar playing.
We're epic. We're epic. I'm talking about. We're epic. I can't forget. We're epic. I'm talking about. Everybody play. California. Oh, let's sing, sing. When you're hearing. When you're hearing. When you're hearing. Ready again? You find it? I hear it now. I hear it now.
Mm-hmm. Party nice again.
Tempo.
I think I'm on to my brain. This feeling I can't explain.
Watch. Watch me go.
Coming to you
like I play that tune, it's so soft. Pull it up. Hold on. Let me see all the people who've been coming to the Fisherman's Day for the last 5 years. Last 5 years? You been here last year? The year before? You coming back next year again? Turn it up now, man.
I think I've gone to my brain.
Whoa!
This feeling I can't
explain. We started it now.
We're starting it now! It seems like a broadcast. As the entertainment continues here at the Callop Wapling Field. We get ready to stay so long. It's been a wonderful evening sharing that with you, and the entertainment continues here. Congratulations to all of those who came out on top in today's Fisherman's Day activities. Tomorrow morning at 9 is when we are expected to have the presentation of those prizes formally. So we'll try to get you coverage on the various platforms, and of course, on especially on social media pages. We hope that you'll be able to follow for those. Team here, NBC Radio, if I make the show.
To my friend, she always supported me anytime we pass here, you know. Alisa Jordan, big up yourself. We have been aboard the party for you, right? Yes, sir. Let me go again. It seems like a oh Lord, that I say deja. Oh no, no, I say deja vu. It feels like a oh boy. Deja vu. Deja vu. Listen. And it's the OG whining.
Yes, I love in this feeling.
I want everybody to give me a nice wine up. What it feels like? What it feels like?
It feels like a
oh, Anna.
I say deja vu. I say deja
vu.
It feels like I've been here before.
When you look around, it's just family and friends, you know. Listen to me, now. Oh Lord, look at me, friend, am I wrong now? Oh, what's shoveling from now? Oh, you came here to get down, down, down.
We gonna have fun.
Hold a gal and
wine, wine.
Hold a gal and
wine, wine.
Hold a gal and
wine, wine. Hold a gal and wine, wine. Hey, gal, now when you wine and go down, girl, you think you want it wrong when you wine and go down, yeah.
Oh, oh.
Yo, 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 yo.
Big up all the mothers inside the house. Hold on, selector.
Hold on, selector. Hold on, man.
Big up all the ladies who cook a nice fish broth. With the snapper, with the okra. Huh? I want the fish and banana, the green banana, the young green banana. Ladies, you can cook a nice fish broth. Just say, whoa, yo! It's trouble again. I don't know this one. You play stand up now.
Who want to talk?
Sing. Who want to talk? Turn up the tape number one, two, three.
I don't want no hot girl, sugar mommy.
Argument, hold on. Play the loop. Ladies. Ladies, listen me carefully, right? Anybody know how to give me a nice pillow? I love pillow. You go cook a nice pillow? That click over here look like you go cook a nice pillow. I want the fish with the okra in the foil paper. You could give me that? You could give me that? You sure? Me no want to fight fry fish and I want fish broth. Huh? I want the fish broth so I could do certain things. I want to start me family. I want to start me family. You had the conks. You know how to punk the conks? That click over said they had the conks. You had the conks. You sure? You sure?
So,
who want to talk? Who want to talk? Can I quah? Can I quah? Sing it out now.
I don't want no hot gal a sugar mommy. I don't want no rude gal, give me a sugar mommy. I done with them school gal, give me a sugar mommy. Oh yes, sugar mommy.
Let me tell you why.
Give me a sugar mommy.
Let me tell you why. Listen.
Sugar mommy go wash and clean and cook and all of these things. She don't want me to catch no van, cause it's a brand new razor potion. Oh, sugar mommy go treat me to lunch when I don't have a cent. You don't see how I looking nice, cause she paying on rent. I don't want no hot gal, a sugar mommy. I don't want no rude gal, give me a sugar mommy.
Uh-huh.
I done with them booze gal, give me a sugar mommy.
Some people flex with me.
Sugar mommy.
I don't care.
Give me a sugar mommy.
Listen. Where you tell them?
I don't care who want to talk or criticize. Cause she not talk no feelings if them gal give me a why. And I don't gotta worry about coming home on time. And she don't even check to see if a man. I don't want no hot gal. I sugar mommy. I don't want no rude gal. Give me a sugar mommy.
Let me look. You know, you have some people that want to take away your local husband and your local boyfriend. And them don't know how to peel the banana. They don't know how to steam down the fish. They don't know how to wash the fish with local lime and them thing. Local vinegar. And if you don't have lime and vinegar, where you lose? Local flour. You know what them thing? You know what them thing? You don't have our nails and can't peel banana. Turn it up, see?
I don't want no hot girl, a sugar mommy. I don't want no rude girl, give me a sugar mommy. I done with them school girl, give me a sugar mommy.
Let me go.
One. Let's give me a sugar.
You sure you do that already?
Hey, who want to talk? Love up your pano. Hey, hey, oi, hey, oi, oi. For the love of pan. Oi, oi.
We do this one already?
Hey, hey. It's music down in deep and yeah.
We don't do this one already.
This vibes it feeling
something so else, good. Man. We don't do this one already. Give me something else. Where's Chanel McKenzie? You can't come from Calaqua and touch the stage and all. Let me make some noise for Chanel McKenzie, please, now, man. Chanel, where are they? You have thing, we coming. We running. You have thing. You know you have thing. Look for it, they right there. No, we coming, don't worry yourself, don't worry yourself. We have thing coming. Listen, July 5th, Uptown Party, Hans John celebrating 20 years in the music industry. We're doing it big. You're talking about international artists such as Olatunji, Problem Child, Hans John, Fireman Hooper. Huh? Big, big, big show at the Uptown Party. July 5th, come sport. I'm inviting all of you to come out and celebrate with me. You understand? You're going up the road? Give me the shellings, let me go up the road. Give me the shellings, let me go up the road. You find it? Until you find it, listen. From we reach by the gate, we party. We don't start a party. It's pure bacchanal, and it's our uptown party. And with a downtown vibes, and it's our uptown party. And with a downtown vibe, is the same bacchanal, same pretty girl, same man a weird, same misbehave. You're supposed to find it now. Good. This is the last song, then I'm gone.
Trouble again.
Whoa.
Trouble again.
Hey. Hey. When we come to rave, don't tell me about me.
Give me a jump.
It's shillings. Hey. Anytime we touch your friend, oh, it's shillings. What you see is what you get. Oh, oh, it's shillings.
They got the whole of epic. They got the weird forest crew. Hey,
my people get mad, 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 mad.
Oh, oh,
we go rip down their soul and push on their soul. My people get mad, 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 mad. We go mash up their soul.
One more.
And shall down their soul.
Listen.
Hey, what a party, bad people out and bad. Let them out the cage on a rampage. Oh, what a party, bad people out and bad. Let them out the cage on a rampage. My people want to play and want to
carry on.
Whoa, whoa,
jamming in the streets all day. Say when we come to rave, don't tell we what we aim. Just let the fire blaze.
I tell you, it's
shillings. Anytime we touch your friend,
oh oh,
it's shillings. What you see is what you get. Oh oh, it's shillings. Tell them to don't come on us. Oh oh, it's shillings.
This is what we are not
going. My people get.
My name is Hans John, the Soca Ambassador, the man with the golden voice, the Uptown Party boss, enough love and respect. I'm looking for all you July 5th, come sport and it's filled. Uptown Party featuring Hans John, Olatunji, you know the guy will say? Play me low, don't play nothing. So just join the line, grab your bottle and spoon. Oh Lord, I'll be party in the engine room. In the engine room, we go jam it steady. I see all your July 5th Hans John representing every time. Love you.
That is what they like.
DJ Cross.
that is what they like.
Jackie got the beats.
Little boy, how will
we'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.